235,000 spectators. Huge fun at the start. 660 drivers.
We're having a good time.
170 race cars. 25.4 kilometers. 52 dropouts. 24 hours on the most dangerous racetrack in the world. The 24-hour race is a dream. The 24-hour race at the Nürburgring. 4 days of pure racing action. And in the middle of it all, our test driver, Patrick Simon. And Patrick will take part twice this year. First off with the oldies at the 24-hour classic in a Scirocco 1. The nice thing when you look at the old Scirocco is the 13-inch tires. Nowadays, every production car has 16, 17-inch tires, so these things look really sweet and cute, but they have real grip. And a look into the cockpit shows you the technology. Not low-tech, just the standard from 30 years ago, and we're going to be driving really fast with and having a lot of fun. The 30-year-old Scirocco goes really fast thanks to a 1.6-liter engine and 190 horsepower. The 825-kilo unladen weight is a guarantee for decent racing power. These are cars that you have to handle carefully, so try to hold our position. We have the class lead already through qualifying, so we have to defend that, and otherwise just have fun. Driving around the Nordschleife early in the morning is a dream. Ten o'clock, Saturday morning, 122 cars roll up to the start line of the 24-hour classic race. In the middle of it is Patrick in his Scirocco. And he immediately fights for every inch. The race lasts 3 hours to ensure fairness in a race involving Porsches and Sciroccos. There are more than 30 classes, but Patrick isn't interested in classes. He just wants to get out in front. And that's where he's heading. Having started in position 28, Patrick pushes the old car towards the lead. Patrick is acquitting himself very well. He's just driving a bit too fast because he has such a lead. He doesn't need to. But I think in 15th place overall we look good. I'll be happy if he maintains that and maybe gets a little higher. But we need to hold him back a bit because the race is still long. Long it might be, but he won't be held back. Patrick only knows one pedal position, full throttle. But eventually Patrick does have to brake. The pit stop is approaching. We'll change in one lap, in the lap after next, and then I'll try to go a bit more gently because we have such a lead over the next car in our class, and then we'll make sure that we make it through to the end. And while teammate Heinz prepares for his stint, Patrick has held his position and comes into the pit in 15th place. The driver changeover is hectic. A couple of quick tips from his teammate and a quick check under the bonnet. Nothing more.
Patrick, wie war's?
Yeah, cool. That was really a ton of fun at the start. A couple of Porsche guys got away badly, then caught up. It's a fight. On the straights, they catch up with you, and then you fight your way past again in the corners. But it was brilliant fun, and for the times I've put in a 38, so that was really very fast. Regular driver Heinz is very experienced on the 25.4-kilometer long Nordschleife. Normally he drives this Scirocco in the Youngtimer Trophy races. And Heinz does his job well. After 3 hours and 17 laps, car number 330 crosses the line as class winner. Wonderful, it went perfectly. Had a great stint right at the start. Heinz thankfully drove it home. We deliberately eased up on the speed. Super job, it was a good start to a long weekend. Now let's see that it stays good in the main race.
ja, beim Hauptrennen auch noch gut wird.
The race was completely problem-free for us, not a single bit of damage, nothing. Everything went to plan and we're more than happy with a class victory and 15th place overall. Patrick's second car at the racing weekend is also blue and also from VW, also a Scirocco. I'm not aiming to win the Golden Pineapple in the 24-hour race, of course. The overall win is out of reach. But that's not what it's about. It's about the car, the package. You have an internal challenge and we want to harmonize as a team. I'm driving with Carlos Sainz. He's a rally driver, Dakar and everything you can think of. El Matador.
Das wollen wir natürlich als Team wunderbar harmonieren, ne?
Depping, Sainz, Kaufmann and Simon, car number 117 is ready for the race. At 4 p.m. exactly, 170 cars begin the fight for the Nürburgring crown. For car number 117, professional rally driver Dieter Depping takes the wheel. Patrick has to wait for now, a tough time for a real race driver. Rush hour on the ring, and while for some the race is already over, after the first lap, Dieter is still spurring on the 315-horsepower Scirocco. Driver change two is still not Patrick's turn. Up before him is ex-rally champion Carlos Sainz. It's only El Matador's second time driving the green hell. Patrick is slowly becoming impatient. He's looking forward to his stint at the wheel and claims to be more concentrated than excited.
Jetzt kommt noch der Nietzwitz. Der kann gar nichts. Nietze!
Ja?
Wenn ich gleich komme, machst du Platz bitte, ja?
Immer wieder gerne.
Ja, super. Ja. Klaus, ist eine Freude.
Wir ja? sind stark befreundet.
NTV, ja?
Wir sind Teamkollegen.
VW has entered the 24-hour race with 5 Sciroccos in total. But even for VW teammates, nothing is given away. It's getting serious for Patrick. Every driver has to complete 9 laps of 1.5 hours in the Scirocco. Then it's time for the next fuel stop. El Matador, Carlos Sainz, comes into the pit in 28th place. The VW team is perfectly rehearsed. 10 men complete the major service in just under 2 minutes. 4 new tires plus 100 liters of petrol, enough for the next stint. And off they go. Meanwhile, the Scirocco GT24 has climbed quite far ahead, from position 47 to 21. But the VWs can't keep up with the leaders. The Sciroccos lose around 30 seconds every lap on the 500-horsepower Porsches and Audis. Nevertheless, Patrick continues to put his foot down and promptly puts in the fastest lap time for a 117 Scirocco, 9 minutes 23. For me, this is the first time that I've had the chance to sit in this car for a long stretch and become one with the Scirocco GT24, and it's impressive. I've never driven a car in all my years where I could get out and be so relaxed after 10 laps. It's warm, but otherwise the handling, changing gears, driving, the whole car is so well configured that it's really, well, wow. Then it gets dark over the Nürburgring, but definitely not quiet. 235,000 spectators pull an all-nighter and make the 24-hour race one of the biggest motorsport events in the world. The next morning, shock in the VW pit for Patrick's team. The car was out on the track around Flansgarten and ran right into the back of a BMW that was creeping along at 40 kilometers per hour in the middle of the track. Unfortunately, the car is now bust. Up until then, we were in second place in our class and it was going really, really well. We had no problems the whole night, 18 hours, and there were no problems with the car. And all 4 drivers had put in good times. And we could have pushed further ahead in the overall order, but now, unfortunately, we're stuck here and we have to watch.
leider stehen wir jetzt hier und müssen zuschauen.
Bad luck, Patrick. However, there's still reason to celebrate. After 142 laps and an average speed of 150 kilometers per hour, another Scirocco wins the class.